Start with MS Word. So this is Microsoft Word is basically made to do Word documents, okay, documents or assignments, yes, or you may even send this as your PDF file as well. For your assignment, you will be submitting with this Word document, yes, basic text. So let's go through this toolbar of the MS Word, basically what it is. Yes, as you can see here, this is a white page. This is nothing but called as the document, doc, okay? The extension for this file would be DOC and DOCX, okay? Let's go through the home tab, basically. The home tab, the main important ones are, this is bold, bolding the text, italics, underlining, yes, this is subscript, this is superscript. Apart from this, you can even increase the size of the content either from here, this drop down, either of this drop down, yes, or you can increase and decrease from here as well. This is for increasing, this is for decreasing, okay. So I am using the text style of Times New Roman, for example. So I start writing, welcome to IT Workshop Lab. For example, I have written two texts. Now, for example, this I want to bold it. So either you can click on this or you may press Control and B together. So that is nothing but the shortcut key for control bold. Okay, I want to make it as italic. The second one, I want to make it italics. What I'll do, Control and I, or you may even click on this, either of them. Now some more text I will add up here. So as you can see, this has come as bold. I want to remove this, the bold option. So you press on Control B and just press Control U or this underline, any either of them. So I want to change the font size for this. So what you will do, either you can click here, it is increasing, right? You can even decrease it using this. The other way is nothing but, as you can see, this is the drop down here which is available. The max size is 72, okay. Min is 8, okay. So I'm keeping some 14 here, okay. This is underline, this is bolding, this is italics. Apart from this, you also got something to do with uppercase and lowercase, okay. Now G section students, Excel is not completed. I will switch over to Excel next. First let me go through Word. This same uppercase, lowercase, bold, italics, underline remains the same in all three, MS Word, MS Excel, and MS PowerPoint as well. Now I want to just type one more line. Okay, for example, I have written this line. Now I want to convert this either to uppercase or lowercase. As you can see here, there are the options. So uppercase, for example, can you see that all the words which are there available here is converted to uppercase. I have written in mixed format, even though I have got it in. Now this I have duplicated it. How did I duplicate? Either you just select the text just press on Control C and Control A and then Control V. What is Control A? Control A is for selecting all the text. All the text. By default, if you press Control A, all the text will be. Or if you want only selected text, you need to select only the particular text like this. Now Shift and side arrow, right side arrow you need to press. Now this is the text which I want to convert it back to lowercase. Okay, let's see how is that done. Just go here and click on to lowercase. So can you see the entire line of text is converted to the lowercase. Is it clear? Next part in this, which you need to know, is nothing but alignment of the text. For example, this is the heading of your document, for example. So what will you do? You should always have the title where at the center. So what will you do? You will just click here. These three are for the alignment of the text. This is left alignment. This is center alignment. This is to the right. And this is to justify. How we will use justify, I will show you that as well. Now I want to align this IT Workshop lab to the center. So just click here. So what is going to happen? It is going to go to the center. And I will just bold it up as it is the title. Okay. For example, I want to align this to the left, for example. So I am shifting this to the left. It has become to the left. This again, I want to put it to the center. Center, I kept it to the center. This I'll keep it at the right. Now coming to justify. Okay. Just I will show you how justify exactly works. Okay. The same text I am copy pasting it for multiple times. Okay. You can have your own text. Okay. Some more text. Okay. Can you see here the lines? One line is starting the ending at the end somewhere else. This is not even, right? This para is not even. So what will I do? I will just highlight all, select it up, and I want to justify. So just click on here, that is Control J. Okay, or you can just click here. So can you see here the alignment? It has come up very neatly. As you can see here, the alignment has come up very, very clean. Yes, all are starting at the same line. They are in line, unlike the previous scenario. Yes, that is alignment of the text. Now, what if I want to give bullet points to this first three lines? I want to give some bullet points. Yeah, now giving the bullet points are in two fashion. One way you can go for this option, that is circle dot tick mark or the arrow mark. The other way you can give even Roman numbers, serial number, ABC. Yes, as you can see here, serial number with this style. This is Roman number, lowercase Roman number, caps. Yes, in any format you can give. For example, I want to give it in this format. So as you can see here, one, okay, this is one. Now I press and enter two, and I press here for three now. Here, as you can see here, V has come by Control V I was typing, so it has come as. So can you see here, one, two, and three. Now from the next, I would like to just put up some bullet points, okay. So I will put the bullet, yes, this style, okay. Just give me an enter, okay. To just classify these sets, okay. Can you see this difference? Yes, this is one more different style. Okay, now I want to just set up for the lowercase Roman numbers, for example, this one. What I will do, just go on pressing one. Enter. It will give the bulleted points. Just give me a second, students. I will be back in a minute. Yeah, students, I'm back. Yeah, so this is giving the Roman number in the lowercase. Okay, lowercase Roman numbers. You can give in the same way for the capitals as well. Yes, this is available here. Okay, all the different. Okay, this is the bulleted. Now here, as you can see, there is no line spacing here. Yes, you can add the line spacing between each of the content. Okay, for example, I will just align this up for you so that you can understand. Okay. Yeah. So just picking up some of the content from here. Okay, first two lines. And now I will just put here, go here. As you can see, by default, it is 1.5. So for example, I want to give 2. Yes, you can. You can give 2.5. It increases. Can you see what is this? Line spacing. This is nothing but line spacing. For example, I want to give it to 1. Can you see here the line spacing? Okay, and the paragraph spacing. You can give the line spacing accordingly, or you can remove the line spacing as well. Yes, it is up to you. This is one more. Now one more task is there, that is nothing but giving borders. This is used for inserting tables. For example, yes, I want to insert some tables here. Before going inserting of the table, let us go for finding any text, replacing any text. So for checking whether the word is present or no, we will press Control F. Okay, this is used for finding the text. Okay, so Control F is for finding. For example, I want to search ITWS. Okay, ITWS. So as you can see here, ITWS, so many occurrences in the file is available. It will show you where it is available. So let's scroll down. You can see wherever IT workshop is there, it is going to map. Okay, just type, for example, I want to type only lab. Can you see here lab? Only lab is being highlighted. For example, I want to do high, select high. So can you see wherever high is there, it is getting highlighted. This is called as finding any text in your document. Now what if I want to replace? If you type Control H, what is going to happen? I want to search something, I want to replace it. For example, here IT workshop is there, right? Small ITWS, lowercase, and I want to replace this ITWS in caps. ITWS in caps. And will I click replace or just click on replace all? Replace will just replace one part, but I want to replace in the entire document. Wherever ITWS is available, that will be changed immediately to ITWS. Yes, replace. So what will happen? Word has completed its search. Okay, there are 37 occurrences of this small lowercase ITWS. So you will press on OK. Yes, and click on close. So there you go. Wherever ITWS was there, it is all replaced with caps ITWS. Now, similarly, I want to replace lowercase I with capital H-A-Y, hey, okay. Just click on replace all. There are 35 such. So it is getting replaced. Let's see. Can you see here? Wherever I was there, it got replaced with H-E-Y, hey, okay. So this is called nothing but finding and replacing in the entire document. Okay. Now, next, this tab is done. Is anyone having any doubts? You may unmute your mic and ask if any. Before switching over to the next tab in MS Word, there are some text effects which you can use for your text in your document. As you can just select and you just type typing, you're going to get in this font style only. Yes, that is text effect. This is for giving the background color. For example, I want to give this highlighting with the yellow color, for example. So I just give go and yellow. Okay. Now just once again, I will change this color to red color. The text color, I am changing it to red. So can you see? I have changed it. So this A, first one, is for font color. This is for highlighting the text or the background color, anything. Okay. So that is what is there available in your first tab, that is of MS Word, that is home. Okay. Next, insert. In the insert, you need to remember two to three things. What are those two to three things? One is insertion of a table. Okay. I am just scrolling down. Okay. Let me take a new page. Okay. This is coming to the page 2. Yes. So I want to now insert a table. Okay. A table consisting of 5 columns and 3 rows and 5 columns, as you can see. Yes. So just click on insert. It is going to give you a table. This is nothing but insertion of the table. Okay. This is how you insert a simple table. Okay. Now, what if I want to insert an image? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Yeah. Just click on this. For example, I want to yes. You need to keep this in correct. Cursor should be placed in the correct area. Otherwise, it will not come. So just click on insert. So can you see the image is inserted? Yes, you can take from your local system. Is anyone having doubt? Five C, do you have any doubt? So that was nothing but inserting of an image. Okay, inserting of an image. You can even insert a clip art. Okay, you can insert different shapes as well. For example, I want to insert one shape of an oval. For example, this is a circle I have selected here. So you can even have text inside it written. Okay. This is common once again. This charts, okay, line, pie, bar, yes, these are the important ones. This can work out in Excel straight away, selecting the data from the table in the Excel sheet, and just you can get the bar graphs which is available here. Yes, this is one more which you need to know. Now, the most important in this MS Word is nothing but the header and footer. For example, I'm going to the third page. Just double click. For example, I'm just double clicking. One second. So either you can double click or you can just click on header and footer. Yes, as you can see here, different styles of header and footer. For example, I'm going for a blank one. Yes, if you double click also, you're going to get the same. Okay, so I'll write here KMIT. Okay, that is nothing but the header. So that is going to come in each and every single page. Can you see here? KMIT, let me increase the font size. Okay, so KMIT. I have written it in the header part. Yes. Now I want to work on the footer. So can you see here footer? Double click. That's it. So it is going to give you the footer. Yes. You can even choose the footer options from here as well. As you can see here, there are three. There are two only. For example, I want to give page number here. You may give here your roll number. For example, roll number colon. Okay. And here by default page numbers are going to come. So as you can see here down second page number two, automatically it will give you the page numbers. Roll number, if you type some, for example, I type the number like 19 capital BD1A054G, for example. So this is going to come in each and every single page. You need not enter manually for each and every single page. This is page number two. You can see in page number three as well. Let me go to the bottom. Yeah, this is page number three. The roll number is going to repeat every single page, one page if you enter. Yes, this is header and footer in MS Word. Next important, you can even insert equations. Yes, you can even insert equations. Okay, just let me scroll down and go to the new blank. Yeah, now here I am going to insert a formula, for example, a equal to pi r square straight away. So you can insert it like this, or the other way, you can use LaTeX software is there, that is GrinDQ. You can inbuilt, it is a plugin which is available. We can plug it in and you can easily convert MS Word or MS Excel or MS PowerPoint into LaTeX coding. Okay, so that will be taught at the later stage, right? Not now. Okay, so this is equation, and the next one is symbols, special symbols, alpha, beta, greater than, less than. This is sigma. Sigma notation is for summing up. If Excel is completed for the students, they will understand this. Rest of you, I will be teaching you Excel after this. Okay, this is inserting of your equations and special symbol. Okay, you have also got this font size already shown in the first tab as well. This is one way. The other way is insert here as well. Yes, and you also got something called as text box as well. Simple text box, alphabetical text box, different. For simple text box, like this one simple text box, you can type data here. Just remove it and type the data here. You can have your styles here, as you can see. Yes, this is one more which you need to remember. Let's switch over to the page layout. Yes, let's switch over to the page layout. Okay, here I have the text in this format. Okay, just let me copy this text from here. Copy. I will make a one page doc now of the same text as it is. So I'm filled up page number 4 with the following content. Okay, it is filled up with this, right? Now, why I'm teaching you this is for, there is a concept of newsletter. Okay, creation of a newsletter. So if you can see, just I am highlighting. Yeah, why? Because the text is not aligned. Can you see here? The alignment is not there. So I am highlighting this particular text, and now I am going to justify it. So how will I justify? Just go here and click here. It is going to be justified. The text is justified now. As you can see, the text is justified, starting and ending. It is perfect. Yes, as you can see here. Now, what I have to do for a newsletter? As you have seen the daily newspapers, you will have some heading on top. At the bottom, you will have the data content in one single column. No, you will have in multiple columns. So how are you going to change that? Can you see here this columns option? This is the page layout tab in MS Word. Yes, so click on columns. As you can see here in the drop down, left, right. Okay, I am more focused to complete my text displaying in two different columns. By default, it is in one single. No point selecting in one single. So I want to split it into two columns. So I split it into two columns. The output looks like this. The orientation does not change. Yes, orientation is nothing but the landscape and the portrait. Okay, when you're printing this doc, you can give it for either a landscape or a portrait. So now, rather than two, I want to split it into three. So it is going to split into three as well. So you can see here, three pages, three different columns, but the data has gone split into two pages, half. Okay. I will convert it back to two columns. Yes, so two columns. Now, apart from this, you got something to do with the option of zooming in and zooming out of this. So as you can see my cursor at the bottom of the screen, you can zoom out. Can you see two pages now? If you reduce more, you can see the overview. Can you see the overview of your doc? How many pages are there? At once, there are 5 pages in your document right now. So once I increase, make it to 100. Yes, making it to 100. So 100 is going to come back. So two columns. This is how you can. Now I want to insert an image here. As you know, in a newsletter, always there will be an image. Okay. This image, I want to insert it here somewhere. Yes. So just image is inserted here. Yeah. Reset it. Yeah. Just align. Yeah. You can align this image as well. Make it small or make it big as per your requirement. Okay. You may even keep it to the center of the text. So you may just press go on entering this. Yes. And you can select this and you may even justify it or left alignment or right alignment. You can even format your images. Okay. You can even format your images. Can you see here? Glassy type, mirror image. Different styles for giving. For example, I want to give it in this format. Can you see here? The shade of that image is coming up. Okay. This is nothing but coming to the page layout option. Okay. Now I want to see how will my page print out? How will it come as a print? So can I see the print preview? Yes, definitely I can see. Click on print and you can see here the print preview. The other option would be Control P, as there is no printer connected to my system. So this is what your preview would look like. Yes, you can give customized page numbers. You can change the page setup for your document. Yes, and you may even increase the number of copies, how many copies you require for your print of your document. Now, most important in this is nothing but there is one concept of watermark. There is another concept of drop cap. Okay. So let me go for watermark first. As most of you must have seen your internal papers of KMIT. Yes. What is that KMIT logo? Shadow sort of thing, right? That is nothing but your watermark. Okay. That is being generated. Or the other example would be you must be downloading question bank of your respective subject from JNTU world. Yes, all jntuworld.com. Can you see that? So there you will see www.jntu.com in this fashion, in the side way. Yes. So any one you can take and use. You may even add an image for your watermark. For example, I want to select this. Can you see it is at the back end? Here it is coming, confidential. Yes, as the text is available, you're not able to see. Wait, I'll go for a blank page, then you will be. Yes, can you see here now? Yes, are you able to see? Are you able to see, students? Yes, yes, okay. So that is watermark. Okay, now let me show you what exactly is a drop cap. Basically, I don't know how many of you must be reading novels, but at the starting of your book, you will see some content regarding to the author or something. Okay, so you will have some text like this. At the starting of the paragraph, the first letter will be in big font size. Okay, so I am selecting in this fashion. Yes, I am selecting in this fashion. You may have it in this fashion or you may not have, but when I ask you to use, you're going to select this. Can you see here? H is caps. The rest of the content in the document remains as it is. This is called as a drop cap. Yes.
Colors. వచ్చింది నాకు అయితే ఒక ఏదో చిన్న పేపర్ మీద చేసిన నాకు అది చెప్పు రాయడం
yes so as you can see here this is nothing but the usage of your drop cap okay this is another important thing which you need to learn in MS Word okay as you can see in this view tab the zoom option yes one which we have seen at the bottom of my screen right here the same thing is here yes you got a scale on top yes if you click here you will see the scaling this is for the margin page setup margins this is you can set it as per the requirement of yours yes you can change the alignment as per your requirement yes apart from this you have got a review tab for example I have written the spelling of world wrong yes see what happens can you see here it became red color so you can just select this and click on spelling and grammar yes so it is giving you suggestions which one you want wild or world it is world as we all know yes and change all yes and close this is nothing but the spell check the other option would be for example I have changed this okay now to well he is missing so you can just select it and just click on right click did you get the options here you may also see here you may add to dictionary if your spelling is not available just choose anyone and click on it so it will automatically change the other alternate would be what I have told you in the initial tab you got a home in that you got replace you may replace all at once either way round is MS Word clear to all is MS Word clear to all there is one more in this that is nothing but mail merge okay mail merge I am going to send you one video so that you will understand better rather than me showing because it works on basically mail merge is nothing but basically writing letters okay writing letters or you can say mail emails to thousands of people okay you need to send that same mail to thousands manually can you do that it is impossible to type copy paste okay that is fine but that is a manual work right so in order to overcome that you create one excel sheet with the specified columns there will be some specified columns for example you will write in the mail I will just give you one template of your mail for example you write your mail like this dear Sam for example गुड इवनिंग, आई एम हैप्पी टू इनवाइट यू फॉर माय प्रोजेक्ट विच बिगिंस ऑन ट्वेंटी 21। फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज द कंटेंट ऑफ द मेल विच आई वॉन्ट टू सेंड टू थाउजेंड। नो डाउट देर इज वन लाइन बट आई वॉन्ट टू सेंड विद दिस सो मेनी सो मच ऑफ कंटेंट एडिंग टू दिस। सो इज इट पॉसिबल एवरी सिंगल टाइम यू चेंज द नेम? सो वॉट विल यू डू एग्जैक्टली? क्रिएट वन एक्सेल शीट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ नेम्स ऑफ द पर्सन्स, नेम्स ऑफ पर्सन्स। The other one would be email ID, okay? Names of persons. I will send you a link for this, okay? G section students, please take it from Johanna madam. I will be sharing the same to Johanna madam. You can get that link of mail merged, okay? Names of persons and email ID. Email ID in the sense the recipients which you want to send. So you can see here, start mail merge option is there. You may choose letter. Mostly we will write letters only. So this is the content what you need to write, or you may choose a normal Word document as well. Anything is okay. Then what will you do? Select what? The recipients. So as I told you, you need to have the column names in the form of name of persons and the email ID. If you have, then you can get here, as you can see here, use existing list. You will have in this Excel sheet only. So automatically 1000 or 1500 you want to send, automatically this mail, you just need to have some anchor type. For example, this content goes like this. This content is going to go straight away like this. For example, this is the name of person. For example, I am giving it. So it is going to take this particular part, name of person, is going to come from your Excel sheet. Whatever name you have given, that will come, and then as it is, the rest of the part is going to come. If you want to add something more which has to come from that Excel sheet, you need to add one more column in the Excel sheet and continue that data here. In which format? In this format only. Why we are using this double anchors? You need to use it because it is a tag which will map it with your Excel sheet, which you're going to select it from here. Select recipients from your Excel sheet. This is existing list, or you may even type in new list. But better to create one Excel sheet so that it will take it up and create your work. That will make your work easier. Okay, this is mail merge. Okay, is it clear so far? Yes. Yes, it is clear, I guess. But can you explain page numbers part again? Page numbers, okay. I will explain page numbers again. So as you can see here, page numbers, right? So I am just removing this up. Okay. How did I get this? This is nothing but the header and the footer. Okay, header and footer. Where is it? It is in insert tab. If you go in insert tab, you get something known as header, which is nothing but top part. With you have got something known as footer. Yes, here you can select either one. The other one is here also, you can give your page numbers. Yes, you can give your page numbers here as well. There are different options to give the page numbers here as well. You have got this. The best one would be this, because this is aligned type. For example, I will give here once again roll number, okay, 19BD1A054, for example. Okay, and just a double click, so you will automatically get page number 5, page number 4. As you can see on top, page number 3 as well. Can you see page number 3? Again 2. Yes, and this is page number 1. Okay, page number 1 with roll number. Is that clear? Roll number. Who has asked that question? 5AD. Page numbers concept is clear. Yes, okay. 5AW, what you want me to explain again? Please unmute your mic and ask. Male part. Okay. So can you explain the sending mail through PX? So as I told you, for the mail part, you have something known as the Excel sheet. The Excel sheet must consist of the following columns. Okay. Names of persons and email ID. Okay. These two columns you should have in your Excel sheet. This is what you will be having in your mail content. So every time you need to type dear so-and-so person, that so-and-so person is going to come from where? It is going to come from here. You need to select from using existing list. This existing list will be in the Excel sheet. You will be having in the Excel sheet. And the mail IDs will also be available in that Excel sheet. If you got any other content which is changing for each and every person, then you have got to put that within this bracket only, making sure that whatever you keep within this, the column name, I'm writing here column name in Excel sheet. So whatever I'm giving the column name in Excel sheet has got to be mapped correctly in this Excel sheet which you're typing. I will be sending you one link for this. That video will make all your doubts clear. Okay. Is that fine? Yes. Now, is MS Word clear? So shall I switch over now to MS Excel? Okay. I'm switching over to MS Excel. Can you see here MS Excel? Yes, 2010. This is the version which I am using. Yes, this is MS Excel. Now, the students, I will be explaining you MS Excel. There are some concepts which you need to learn up. Yes. So what are they? VLOOKUP concept is there, something related to email. Yes. Yes, something related to your email. Yes, I will be showing you how to calculate the sum average. Yes. So let me go through quickly. Now, for example, I am having the column name of roll number. Yes. I am having something known as email ID. Okay. marks 1, marks 2, marks 3, marks 4. Only 4 marks I am having. I will calculate sum here. I'll calculate average here. I will calculate count here. Okay. Now, my roll number is apart from this, I will also have the upper and lower case as well, which is already covered in MS Word. That same concept comes here. So I am giving some roll numbers randomly. Okay, 501, for example. Yes, and I am dragging these numbers straight down. 10 numbers I am having. Okay. Now, email ID, as you all know, it should be something at the rate gmail.com or something, right? So I want to write roll number at the rate kmit.in, for example. So how will I go about? So very simple, is equal to, you open the bracket, give A2. What is this A2? A2 stands, indicates this is the cell address for this 19BD180501. That is the data. Yes, what is the cell? This is the cell address. Yes. So let me just remove this. So let me explain what is a cell. Yes, this. Can you see here? This is the cell address. First column name followed by row number. So that is the cell address for you all. Yes, these are the sheets. This entire thing is known as a Excel spreadsheet, and it is called as a basically a workbook. A workbook basically consists of 3 worksheets. You may go on increasing your worksheets as well. Okay, now coming back, switching back to the email ID, I'm going to write as A2. Okay, it is not plus sign. Okay, it is equal to symbol, equal to A2 and percentile. I have told I am going to give something like at the rate gmail.com. Okay, and now what am I basically doing here? I am appending or concatenating the data. What is the roll number? 19BD180501. Yes, and percentile I'm using. And what am I adding here? At the rate gmail.com. Okay, and now press and enter. So can you see here what I have got? The roll number at the rate gmail.com. Whatever you write within the double quotations, you are going to get. So I'm just dragging it like this. I may get for all the roll numbers. Okay, next I am switching over to your mark. Okay, so just let me center this up. So some marks I am going to write up. For example, for these many students I want to write. Yes, so for example, I have written some marks. I want to calculate the sum. One way would be just go select the data, go to the sum, click here. Auto sum option is there. Yes, once you click, you're going to get the sum. Yes, did you get? or the other way would be write the formula equal to sum of, this is a predefined function, sum of what is this C2 to F2, that is called as the range. Till what range that particular sum is. Okay, now I am just dragging it down. So I am getting all the totals for each of them. Yes, similarly, you can do it for average as well. Clicking on average, so what it will do? C2 to G2. G2 should not be calculated. Okay, so only till F2, the range is. Okay, capital F2. Yes, this is the average. Okay. Here G2 was also getting calculated, means this will also be considered. So be careful of that. So range has to be selected correctly. Yes. Now, what is this count used for? Okay. This count, why I am doing? Okay. I am want to just write equal to count of, yes, you just select this, how many students it is, okay, range, and press on enter. So how many there are? There are 5 only. Let's check. One way you can see at the bottom, yes, average is being displayed. Yes, average is being displayed for that column. For that particular column, this is column, this is rows, okay, and this is the sum for this column. Yes, this is the zoom in and out. So can I see here the count as 5? Can I see the count as 5 at the bottom? Yes, so that is what is being displayed here. Yes, same way I will be writing here equal to count of, for example, I want to select this range. What will I get? It should be only selectable F. Count of C5. Yes, count of C5. Count of C5 to F5 is nothing but how much? Only 4. Is it correct? Yes, no. C5. This is C5. This is 4. So that's why the count is 4. Okay, that is one more concept which you need to understand. Now coming to upper and lower case, very simple. Yes, just write equal to upper of which column? This column you take up, this roll number column, you just pick it up. Okay, what is that? A2. Enter. So can you see all the alphabets which are there in this is getting converted to the uppercase. So I am just dragging it down. So did you get everything? Yes. Now I want to convert it back to the first row, how it is. Are you going to write here A2? No. You need to write J column, J2. And press enter. So did you get the first row how it is? As it is, you have got here equal to lower, equal to upper. Okay, this is email ID, the destination and percentile @gmail.com or kmit.in, whatever will be asked. So this is calculating the sum, this is calculating the average, this is counting the things. Okay, apart from this you can even sort the names, okay, sorting of names and finding of the duplicates. Let me shift to the next spread worksheet so that you can understand. So I am typing some names out here. Okay, few names I have taken up here. So I want to arrange them in ascending, either in ascending or in descending. So what will I use? The sort one, sort function, either A to Z. Did it sort it out? Yes, it is sorted out. If I want to sort it as per Z to A, did it sort it out? Yes. In reverse, in descending. Now what if I want to filter some of the data? Okay, so I am writing here some column headings, name, okay, followed by department, yes, followed by salary. Okay, now I will write some department names, okay, accounts, okay. Three people are in accounts, okay, marketing and HR, and this is sales, okay. Now salaries. Some values I am just putting it up. Okay, I have given some values. Now accounts, I want to color it up with yellow color. Okay, yellow color, I am coloring it up. Okay, and marketing and HR, I will color it in red. Okay, why, I will tell you. Now what I want to do, I want to filter the cells which are consisting of colors. Yes, there is one option of filter here. Okay, you got three options here. One is filter by cell value, cell color and font color. Okay, first I will filter by cell value. What is going to happen? The ones which are there in accounts are going to be displayed. Can you see rest are deleted? No, they are not deleted, they are hidden. Why? Because the filter has been turned on. Yes. For suppose I want to select accounts and marketing. Can you see accounts and marketing? It has got displayed. What if I want sales and accounts? Will it come? Yes, it is going to come. Now I am going to remove accounts. I will just put marketing and sales. Can you see the filtering? It has happened. It is definitely, it is working. Now I want to turn off this filter. How will I do that? Yes, you may go here and turn off your filter, reapply. Okay, just click on okay. Yes, you're back to your, now I want to filter by cell, filter by cell color. Can you see it has filtered by cell color? Cell color is white. it is not cell font color, for example, font color. So that is in red. So it is getting filtered out with red color. Yes, that is filtering concept. Yes, this is what you need to learn. Apart from this, you got by common bold, italics, and underline. You got the font sizes. Yes, font size. Indenting the text to greater, increase, and decrease. This is background color, font color for your text. At the same time, you can even merge the cells. For example, I want to merge it up here. KMIP. Yes. Can you see here? Merge. Let me give border so that you can view that. Okay. All borders I am giving. Yes. Can you see? It is line. Now, I want to give some more text below this. Hyderabad, for example. Now this I want to give a wrap text. What is going to happen? Let's see. Now I want to reduce this size. I'll reduce this size. This one. Can you see the text wrap? This is called as text wrap. Why it is coming in multiple lines? Because you have merged these cells and as well as you have used a wrap text. Yes, what if I want to align this text in some angle? So I will be just clicking like this. So can you see here, there is one icon here. You may put it like this, for example, or you may even put it text down. This is one way. The other way, this is the best. Yes. So you may have it in this fashion as well. Okay. This is filtering. Okay, now there is one important concept which you need to know well, that is duplicates in the data. Okay, let's have some roll numbers. Okay, roll numbers we will take up. Pull up some roll numbers from here. We will take the entire list. We will take up. Yes. Now in the second list, we will put only few numbers. I'm cutting it. Pasting it here, pasting this somewhere here. I will paste this to the top and I will take this and paste it somewhere here. Okay, now only few numbers are here. The numbers which are mapping will be highlighted. Let it be wherever. So let me teach you now how to find the duplicates. Okay, just select both the columns data, go to conditional formatting. Where is this conditional formatting? In your home tab only, home tab of your MS Excel, you got something known as conditional formatting. Here you got one option of highlight cells rules. Highlight cells rules. In that, you got greater than, less than, and option. But now I want to find the duplicate. So duplicate values. Yes, conditional formatting. Highlight cells rules. In that, you got one option of duplicate values. Where is it? In the home tab, you got conditional formatting. In that, highlight cells rules. And in that, you got duplicate values. So once you select, what will happen? One pop-up window would come up. One pop-up window will come up. Yes, it is giving you the option of duplicate or unique. But I want to give duplicate. You can select the colors as per your requirement. I want red color with dark red text. Okay, select and click on OK. So what is happening here? This is the list. Whichever is mapped is coming as the highlighter. So I have kept it here. This 502 is here. 503 is somewhere here. It is mapping with it. 505 is here. It is mapping. Yes, 507 is also there in the list. Yes, it is there. Yes, 505 is on top. Yes, wherever you keep, this is nothing but finding out of the duplicates in two separate columns. Yes, is this clear so far? Conditional formatting. Yes, giving the text colors, background colors, aligning the text, merging the cells. Yes, concatenating the data, finding some average, okay, upper and lower case. Yes, so far I have covered. There is one more concept, important concept, nothing but VLOOKUP. Okay, VLOOKUP, it's a predefined function. VLOOKUP, okay, it's a predefined function. Let me check if anyone is having any sort of doubts. No doubts, anyone? Okay, yeah. Now, what exactly do you mean by VLOOKUP? Okay, now in this VLOOKUP, we have two different styles. Okay, one is using a single workbook, the other is using two different workbooks. I will show you now one single workbook. Okay. So let me take yesterday's data only. For example, I have this data, okay. Just remove this column for time being, okay. Remove this as well, amount, okay, as of now. And this color has to be printed, okay. This color has to come from here, okay? It will not come from anywhere else, okay? You may have n number of columns, but the main important thing which you need to remember is nothing but you need to have one column name common in both the tables. So as you can see here, product name, yes? So color. So how will you do that? Using VLOOKUP, okay, this is the formula, VLOOKUP. okay is equal to VLOOKUP of what are you going to do searching on the product name. So the first row in the product name, that is nothing but A2 comma, take the, as you can see here, range, table range. From here you will scroll down. Yes, and did you get the range here? D2 to E5. Yes. Next, you will type comma 2 because they are using two columns here, comparing with two columns. And the last option is false. You press an enter. So what will happen? It is going to give you the values as per the table. Yes, just let me once. I'll change this order itself so that you students will understand. Yesterday someone asked me from F section, please jumble this and show it us. So why this is not coming? Because this is not within the range. D, this is D2. So let me just remove it all. Yes. Once again, I'm typing equal to, you should never do what I have done just now because it is not going to take up correctly. A2 comma, select all, comma 2 comma false. False is for exact match and true is for approximate match. I won't always say exact match. Yes, now you will get for all. Why is it not working for paper? Some issue with the paper. So why this NA is coming? Because I am changing it always. Yes, what is happening? These addresses will not map. Whatever you save first time, that data will only take into consideration and it will work. Okay. You should never change the data after you apply this VLOOKUP. So let me just delete all and recreate once again. Delete. I need to take the data once again. Control C, Control V. Okay, I will change the names now. Okay, I'll take the other example. Okay, go. Okay. no amount, I don't want amount. Okay, the cost, let's say 15, 12, 20, and 25, for example. Okay, and I want to get the color based on these. Okay, Control C, Control V. Hope will be in black. This will be in gray color. This will be in orange, and this will be in again here black. Let's see whether it will work out. Okay, equal to, we look up of capital A2 comma to get the range, comma 2, comma false. I'm changing the. Did you get now? Why I didn't get before? Why? Because range was not within. Yes. What is my range? It is from these only. From where? That is F3. Okay. F3. G3. Okay. Then F4. G4. Yes, then 5 and then 6 within this range. But when I'm coming here, what it is taking? The down part. So when you are dragging it down, you should be careful. You need to be careful with these range values, compulsory range values. You need to be very, very careful. Your changes, your answer will be wrong. Yes, is that clear? This is using one single workbook. This is using one single workbook. Okay. Now, what if I want to do for two different workbooks? Okay. Let me show you for that. This is one. Let's close this. Yes, this is one workbook. Okay. The other workbook is this. So here I will remove the cost. I will put just color and product. Okay. This columns will not be there. Okay, just give color here, for example, black, caps black, okay, orange and gray, okay. Now in this, based on these two sheets. Okay, sheet 1 and sheet 2, these are okay, two different sheets. These are completely based on this first sheet. You are going to get the colors from this sheet. You need to get the colors into this. How? In the second sheet, you are going to put in the colors. Okay, you are not going to use this table at all. So you will not have this table here. So you will be straight away deleting it off. Okay, this is table number 2. Table number 2 and workbook 2 and sheet 2. Sheet 1 will have this product name and the color. So now this color, I need to put it up in this sheet. Okay, here I will put up the VLOOKUP. So before putting that VLOOKUP, what you will do in the second sheet, go to the view tab. Go to the view tab. You have got one simple instruction of arrange all. Arrange all. Yes, click that. Just click that. What you will get once you click on arrange all, there is an horizontal option. There is a vertical option. Select the vertical option. Did you get? Yes. Now I am going to easily work on my two sheets is equal to VLOOKUP of what? The cell address, the first cell address. I am looking out for the product name. So from here, in the first scenario, what I did, I selected it from the same sheet. Now I am selecting it from two different sheets. This is one sheet. This is another sheet. So did I get the book? This book one is nothing but my file name. This sheet number along with the what? It is the range. This part dollar symbol, everything is nothing but the range from A2 to B5. Comma 2, comma FALSE and press and enter. So did I get Pepsi Caps Black? Yes, it is. Just drag it down. Did I get it? Fanta is orange. Yes, Fanta is orange. Coke black and Limca is in gray color. So did I get it? This is using VLOOKUP U for two different workbooks. The scenario one was just single workbook. This is two different workbooks. The formula is pretty much simple here. The VLOOKUP, the column name which you are looking out for. What is that column? It should be a common column which is available in table 1, which is also available in table 2 as well. And apart from that, you got something known as the range. What is that range? Which you are going to take the help from the table, lookup table. This is nothing but the lookup table. Yes, and you are going to give two column names as you are comparing and comma false. Yes, why false? False is for correct exact match and true is for approximate match. When you're typing only the formulae, you're going to get it. So as I'm typing here, true or false, can you see true or false? So either one. So I'm choosing false. Okay, false, and press and enter. Yes, that is the formulae. Is it clear so far, Excel? Apart from this, calculating and everything, you have the same sort. Yes, that equations which I showed you in Word document, symbols, word art. Yes, then you have even the graphs. here pie chart, graphs, everything. Okay, now I want to present this table. Okay, this table I am taking. Okay, and I want to plot a graph, for example. Can you see here? This is only for Limca, it has come. I'm deleting it. Let's go like this. Just two columns I want to plot, for example. Let's go for, rather than this, let's go for the marks one. Marks will plot easily. What is it? Yes. Marks is going to give you a clear picture. Either you can go like this or here. Okay, let's go for this. Can you see here? Series 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, what is series 1, 2, 3, 4? Basically, these are the series. Yes, these are the series. So there is nothing but the series. So you can see here. When I click here, you're going to get the selected one. This gray color is nothing but marks 4. Blue color, the first column. This is second column. This is third column. This is the fourth column. Yes. So this is how you can present graphs, as well as you can even plot pie charts as well. For example, I want to select this. So can you see here? Similar way, this is the, you can select, you will get. Yes, you can see here. How many got 45? How many got 45? Yes, you can see all the marking, how much percentage equal, whatever data is there available here, you're going to get. Yes, this is plotting of the graphs, which is common. Yes, picture, again, picture you can copy and paste it. How? Very much simple. Go here, right click, click on copy, come back here. I'll go to a new sheet so that you can otherwise come here. Okay, click on either copy and paste, or yes, you can directly click here. One way would be this. This is the best option. Click on insert. So you can resize this image as well. Yes, you can resize this image as well. Even you can have audio video clips as well involved in this Excel sheet as well. Yes, you got some formulas. Okay, some of the formulas already I have gone through, mathematical, average, sum, count. Yes, you got something related to date and time as well. Yes, even you got some trigonometric functions as well. Let's go through some trigonometric functions. Okay, equal to sine of 90. You will get the approximate value here, equal to 1. Okay, this is 1. Let's go for some one date or month. Okay, what you can write here, returns the month, a number from 1 to 12. You write the current month is 2. So press on OK. You're going to get So you have got here time, second, okay, today. For example, we will click on today and click on OK. So what will happen? You will get today's date. Clicking on today, this is not there, just I am teaching for extra, okay. These functions you can go through. You got mathematical trigonometric functions, inbuilt trigonometric functions, okay. Mostly use these ones. I am going to ask you in the exam, so concentrate on those. Okay, and yes, one more important one which I need to teach you. Freezing of the panes, okay. Thank you. Okay, for example, I have this many students, okay, in this. Giving ABAB only, okay, don't mind, okay. Now I want to freeze this first row. So what will I do? I will just go to view tab, okay, the header, the column, main first row I have selected, freeze the top row or freeze the panes also. So freeze the pane. Okay, now what will happen? Let's see. It is freeze. That will not move. First row will not move. See, I'm moving the down part. I'm moving the down part. So 5 0 1 2 3. It is going up. First row is not moving. Now I will freeze the column as well. Same way, freeze the first column. Yes, now this top and bottom. Can you see? I have freeze the first column. What if I press on freeze panes? Freeze the panes. Okay, what is going to happen? You see now. What has happened? I have taken the amount to 12, first 12 rows that got freezed up. Yes, so I am just unfreezing them. Okay, so always you can either freeze this row or you can freeze this column. Okay, that is freezing. By default, you have a spell check here as well. Yes, you got the page layout here as well. You got the orientation. You got the margin setup for the printout. In this printout, you can view here at the bottom. Yes, this is the outline as I showed for you in the Word. This is nothing but the print preview. If the margins are getting cut off, you can align this as well before you give the print. Yes. So that's what is all for your MS Excel. Yes. Is that clear? F section students, you have got exam, right? The other exams, if you are ready to write, you can write the exam very well. If you are interested, if you can write it up tomorrow, or you have the other alternate of writing it on Monday afternoon at 2:30. Yes, please decide, and the CR has got to tell me when you students want to write. Yes, I didn't teach you HTML. Yes, right. Yesterday you were not there in the class. HTML I taught, no? Who has asked that question? Roll number 5BM. Were you not there yesterday? Yes, you have doubt in HTML? But it isn't clear. Okay, fine. Let me open up that HTML coding for you yesterday. Okay, I discussed the HTML yesterday. That is nothing but HTML. Okay, this is the first tag, title. This is the title which will be displayed on top of your browser name. Yes, this is the body. I am giving the text alignment to center. Yes, here. And let me write one more here. Okay. H1, okay, and just let me write down welcome and just write H1 and close the tag. Okay, clicking on save. Okay, what is this exactly? HTML is used for, it is used for basically for designing of the web page. Okay, designing of the web page. The starting of the HTML is this title, the title bar where you will get it on the web browser top. Okay, whatever you write in the body will be displayed onto the your web page. So here I'm writing P style text align center. Okay, this welcome will come to the center. One more line I have written. These are the header tags. You got till six like this header tags. Okay. You may even have a break option as well. Here, if I write BR, there is one option like BR. Just click on save. Yes. So just let me execute this so that you can understand. Open with, it is always with a browser. Can you see here? The title IT Workshop Lab. Yes, IT Workshop Lab. Yes, this is the one. What is that? This is nothing but your welcome. H1 tag has come up here. Yes, you have aligned the text to center. The first welcome, that is this line output is here. Now, this welcome is for this line. I have put a break, so there is a gap here. 2 for this line and there is no break here, so there is no gap here. By default this much gap will be there. H3 IT Workshop Lab. So close. That's it. Basic HTML I am going to ask you, nothing more extra. Okay, yes, you may leave if you, I am done with my class. If anyone is having doubts, you can ask. Yes, you have only till body only. Only the body part only. I am not asking you more advanced in HTML, even for the exam. Is anyone having any doubt? You may unmute your mic and ask.